Let's try the north door. Alright, we've got somebody that wants to fight us. We will gladly oblige. More mutants. Or, yeah, skull hunters. Starting right off the bat with a hailstorm. Oh. Yeah, I don't want that. What is my major malfunction? There we go. Is Ice Pitter... Still not sure if it's supposed to be Ice Biter and it's a typo or a mistranslation. But these things aren't undead. I could cast... Was it Destroy Undead? Instead, I just hang out. You see that? I just have him cast that because he can't reach anybody right now. He didn't drop in here. I have him attack this one. Following up with some ice balls. And that's it. Some good hits in there. And 11 drove Manera, taking some damage. Grab band hit for 22 and an 18. And this guy is a complete disappointment to the Skull Hunter clan. So sad. Don't want... What was it? Going into move? No. Spell. Ice balls. I'm gonna move off to this one. Because they're probably gonna destroy that one this round. Someone needs to be healed, I'm sure. Gaben? Yeah. Hit for 13 and 13. That's pretty good. Six and 20, okay. The one on the left has redeemed himself, I suppose. Attack this one. You attack this one. Silk will move up. Magic ice balls. I need healing. Garband is the most, I think. Yeah. Okay. Looks like he's full now. No damage, no damage for both of those. Nine damage on Gribban, otherwise they all basically... their attacks are ineffectual. Silk could start attacking here. Gribban is down exactly 9 points, so yeah, we did fill him up. If anyone needs can stand some healing points, that would be Jovenir. Boop. And boop. Trasric, save his mana. Let's see. He's only got one Hailstorm already. He needs some more mana. I'm looking forward to leveling him up. I hope at least twice after all this. We're getting a lot of experience from these guys, but I think every level you go up, you end up... you need more experience points just to get to that level, so it offsets it. You get more points, but the distance between is greater. We're all attacking, and one healing. Good hits in there. Nice. Number 2 and 3 down. Specifically had him attack the last one, and they missed anyway. Yeah, we're good now. Finish him off, Jovenir. Thank you. Alright, so what's in here? Just some tables and things? Books over here. As you take one of the books from the shelf, it immediately falls to dust. Huh. And yet we're taking it from outside the room. Guess these books are not going to be useful. Did I look at this? I looked at myself, I guess. Yeah, because she's the leader. Okay. Yeah. Any secret doors? No. Alright. We do have a lot of rooms to go in. I don't want to go downstairs unexpectedly. Okay, so north door, now the east. So here's these. We could actually be able to read those books, but we can't. What do we have here? On the table, you discover a dusty old book. Melgrim's Diary. Exciting. I'll take that. Let me look around this area first. Anything else on the desk? Wad of paper? Torches? I like this song. secret walls. Alright, let's look at Melgrim's diary. Most pages of the diary have been destroyed by the weather. The only entries you can still read are the following. 1. After so many years, I now have the magic spells and equipment required to put my plan into operation. Tomorrow I will investigate the secret of life and immortality. 2. Damn. What a time for a fault in transformer number... ...3. All is in order. Tomorrow I will try it, and if everything works as I planned, I'll be the best and most powerful wizard ever to exist in Lyramion. The last entry you can still decipher is very unclear and difficult to read, and you imagine it was not written by the same person who made the previous entries. Interesting. Someone else took over Melgrim's diary. 4. I believe this will be the last entry in the diary. I feel my spirit is disappearing, and my body is changing. Maybe it was the same person, but that person is changed, you know. But the changes are not as I wanted them to be. I believe I was too ambitious and am being punished by the gods. Alright, so he tried to be the most powerful wizard ever, and then his spirit started disappearing and his body was changing. And this he did not want. He was too ambitious and am being punished by the gods. Let me just look at this again one more time. Magic spells and equipment required. He was investigating the secret of life and immortality. One of these transporters, I guess, has a fault in it. I don't know if it's one of the ones we encountered, or one we've yet to see. Alright. Let us try the west door. This is the Knight's Hall. It looks as if it hasn't been used for centuries. On the west wall of the room, there is a large shelf with hundreds of richly decorated wine goblets. As you examine the goblets in more detail, you discover that they have been made from human skulls. Really? And there's a skeleton. Oh, and there's a thing to fight over here. Pardon me while I get up from this chair. I don't want to fight you while I'm sitting in the chair. We got more of these things. Yeah, hailstorm. Hit there, and let me take a look at this ice bitter. 13 more rounds of ice ball. I will use. Do we need to be healed? I don't think so. Yeah, I'll wait. Boom. One of them got 60 damage on it. Pretty awesome. Skull hunters will not take our skulls, not today, baby. We'll attack this one. You know, I'm probably... Yeah, I'm gonna... Damn it! I don't know what I'm doing. You attacking that. You attacking this. I'm gonna fast forward, though. Because you guys have already seen two battles of this now. And done. And doors to some kind of tunnels or crypt or something. Anything interesting here? Oh, we got a chest! Anything with these? I did look at this, right? Yeah. Right, let's check out the chest. Let's just look at these. Keep checking the torches in case maybe we can take some or there's some kind of secret with them. The only thing you find in the chest is a small key. And what if this is the key to free that girl? Cell key? Well, I'd say yes. Well, I'd love to give it to Silk, but he can't hold it. What's up, Silk? Got no slots? You got no slots. Who has these? These are the minor magic potions, I think? Give them to Satine. Now, who ended up taking them? Trashrick? Yeah. That should be for Silk. There we go. So yeah, it said there was nothing else in there. So I want to head back and free her. We got some skeletons over there. We can cheat and look at things even though we're not in the room. I guess we'll fight these things. Should we? They might be tougher than regular skeletons. They might, yeah. Let's go downstairs, because I'm sure we can't, yeah, we can't rest here. For whatever reason. So go back downstairs. We still have the rest of the west door and the south door to check out. But at least here, we can rest. Nothing around the corner waiting for us? Okay. Yeah, once more. I don't think anyone could take these 95 rations now. Much less the others. So yeah, I'm gonna do this off screen again. Cause it's kind of boring to watch. Alright, yeah, I didn't fast forward, I just skipped it, because I forgot to even record it, so... Let's go our protections up once again. Back into the fray here. On these skeletons. Greetings! They're dead? Okay. As you enter this room, shock passes through your body. Everywhere in the room lie skeletons with a skull missing. Oh, like we found outside. But on a table is a skull which is dressed with precious stones. In the fireplace burns a strong fire in which large lumps of meat are being burned. The smell makes you feel sick. In the southwest of the room, you see an open pit. Alright, so these aren't skeletons that will attack, okay? I figured they would be. What do we have here? Next to the skull, you find a few gems, okay? Are these ones that will... I'm assuming these are ones that will that will stack with Satines. I believe they are, because I don't think she had that much room in her inventory. Now we have 18 gems. Before we came in here, we had 11. Pit. Mm-hmm. Fireplace. I thought we were going to fight these things. I was like wondering why they weren't coming out of the open door. Now I just saved. Where's this pit go? Can I see what's... No. What's on the bookshelf? Maybe from here. After a short drop, the shaft turns into a smooth slide, which slopes down into the depths. We're back outside. Okay. After sliding down a dark shaft for a short time, you see before you the weak green glow of the opening above the entrance to the castle and lands in a great disorder on a pile of bones. Oh, no, never mind. I was restarting my timer in the middle of it. I messed that up. We're starting over. After sliding down a dark shaft for a short time, you see before you the weak green glow of the cave. The whole group falls through the opening above the entrance to the castle and lands in great disorder on the pile of bones. Well, I guess we all took some damage, like a point or more. 5 points. 7 points. 9 and 4 and Silk took 7. Well, we don't want to be starting over here. But if we need to get out, that's a way. So let's just keep that in mind and load up. Alright. Okay, so we still have the south door going off there, off the main, and then we've got this, whatever this is. Just looking at everything. Secrets. Oh, something coming out of here. Attacking more of these things. Hurry! Throwing some hailstorm up your buttocks. Okay. We have dispatched the foes. You hear the sound of a fuse sputtering, then there's a bang and the area is filled with blinding light. Alright, we're blind except for whoever's... Okay, which... Walk in here. You hear a slight hissing, and suddenly the area is filled with shimmering green mist. Alright, can I, even though I'm blind, can I cast neutralize poison? Here we go. The spell fails. Is that because I can fail, or because I can't cast it while blind? Okay, I can cast it while blind. Okay, I am also poisoned. Neutralize poison. No, healing, not healing. Remove curse. Okay, so I don't have... Which I suppose is stun, sickness, rejuvenation. So for blindness, we have potions. There's five of us blinded. No blindness. Okay, is this kind of half of an arrow kind of thing going on? That's heal blindness, and I think an herb does that as well. I'll use the potions first. No. Okay, it's aging, madness, poison, and stun. Okay, so we have four of these? If not, we're screwed. I have one. Silk has one. Graban has one. Two. Is that enough? We had one, one, and then two. I think we have just enough, then. We have two. Two, three, four, five. Okay. So, why come in here? I know this is kind of cheating, but I'm like, why go in there then? No reason to go in there. We can heal all our blindness, but we have nothing left. And I don't want to be stuck. So yeah. You can consider it me cheating if you want. Now, south door, the last one. This is apparently the bedroom of the owner of the castle. It looks as if it has not been used for many years. A thick layer of dust covers the bed, and cobwebs have draped themselves over the bed frame. Just out of curiosity, do I normally have that spell? For healing. Now I think rejuvenation. Calm panic, remove irritation. I have blind, but don't have take away blind. Salvation, I think, is healing everybody a certain amount. I remind myself what rejuvenation does. If we even find that out, I think the spells are on 37 or something. Oh, rejuvenation is correcting unnatural aging. Salvation is a party-wide heal. Heal blindness. I don't have that one. What if you can even heal yourself, since you're, you know, blind? I guess so. I mean, I was able to cure people's poison, even though I was blind. Oh, wait. Alright, we're in the bedroom of this... the owner of the castle, who has changed into something. Doesn't this table look weird? Alright, nothing with the table. maybe a chest. Can't do anything with that. The dresser or whatever. Checking out everything. No secret doors. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Alright, let's check this out. Oh, silk. Trap found and disarmed. The lock has been opened. In the chest, you find a large quantity of gold and a key. 6420 gold, which you will not pick up. Unfortunately. Master key. Look at that. Again, silk can't carry it. How sad. I'm gonna leave the gold. Maybe I'll come back for it, if we ever need it for anything. It's not too hard to get- well, it's kind of hard to get to the castle, but once you're inside the castle, not too hard to get to this area. You take the packet of herbs. And Silk will take the master key. Alright, so we got a cell key and a master key. Let's head back to that girl and let her out. Which is back down to the southwest. Southeast, sorry. Right here. I'm pretty sure. Did I see that? I don't remember this. Oh, this is the one where that was crossed out. I can't look at it again, apparently. Many eye was crossed out and put in its place. With the name Many Eye, I'm wondering if it's a beholder type thing. Find out. So south. Get over there, yes, south. Southwest, and then south some more. Can I get through here? Yeah. Around the corner. Guess what I got? The key to get you out. Not the master key, but the cell key. Door has been opened. As you walk up to the girl, you see her body start to tremble, and shortly afterwards it dissolves into a gray mass. Of course it does. As you recover from the shock of the frightful transformation, the mass forms into a huge caterpillar-like beast whose many tentacles reach out towards you.